Ever since I was a little girl, I dreamed of owning my own tattoo shop. I wanted to, quite literally, make my mark on the world. I know, it's cliche, but whatever, I was 10. So, here I am, 15 years later, and my dream has come true. I have a shop of my own, a haven for creative expression. How can I put this? I believe with every fiber of my being that tattoos are a window into the soul. With a tattoo, my art should be able to tell the world who you are and what you are all about without ever having to say a word. Unfortunately for me, my clients show me time and time again that tattoos are nothing but meaningless whimsies in a one-size-fits-all world. Every day, I choke down the bitter taste my dream has left in my mouth and wait for the moment when I will be inspired once again. But I'm not holding my breath.
I'm not too late, am I?
That depends. What would you have in mind?
Oh, it's a small tattoo, three little birds inside the wrist. That's it.
Okay. Fill this out, please.
I really appreciate this. Man, I've been trying all day to get here, and what I thought was yet another wrong left-hand turn on the 3rd Street led me right to your shop. And I'll tell you this, my friend, you are harder to find than a needle in a haystack, just so you know.
Yep. Well, you found me. So, yeah, have a seat, huh? Ugh.
Your shop is awesome. Like, Robbie's description was like right on the money. You know, it's clean, but edgy. A little hostile, but still welcoming at the same time. It's awesome.
Thanks, I think. Who's Robbie?
Oh, he's my brother. He actually came in about a year ago, but...
Oh, let me guess. Punked out?
Yeah. Yeah, he couldn't bite the bullet. But, here I am. I'm Finn, by the way.
Cora. Thought you had in mind?
Oh my god. Are you kidding me? Yes, totally. That's... You know what? I just kept on telling myself, like, Finn, if you just get here, just be awesome. Because this has been one of those days. Like, you know, like, my alarm didn't go off this morning, so I got to work late, and then I had to leave work early to get here, and then, like, I was stuck in traffic for, like, 15 and a half hours, and then I got 10 different wrong directions on how to get here. Spilled coffee in my lap. That was hilarious. And, but, you know, I just kept on telling myself, Finn, if you get here, you know, it'll work itself out. Because Robbie...
Okay. Let's get this party started, huh? Okay?
Party. Alright.
Alright.
Yeah. Let's... You ready? Yeah. No. Yes. Yeah. No guts, no glory.
Is that okay?
Yeah. No pain, no gain.
You got it, dude.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. So you're probably wondering why I'm getting this tattoo. You know that Bob Marley song? Three Little Birds? Three Little... You know. Don't worry about a thing that hurts. Well, I'm trying that out as my new motto for like life. Don't worry.
Trying out? Mr. Clean Cut, excited, smiles, is trying out Bob Marley as a permanent tattoo.
Yes.
Ooh. You know what? That's bullshit, buddy. Don't you people realize? A tattoo is a way to express your innermost self.
Yeah.
All you jokers come in here and trivialize the opportunity to actually say something by demanding one cliche after another. Mm. I sit here all day, just waiting for someone to come in here with an ounce of substance. Mm-hmm. But what do I get? Tramp stamps, butterflies, and Bob fucking Marley. I'm so sorry. I have never done anything like this before.
Wow.
This is permanent.
Cora.
This is not fine.
Cora, okay. Cora, listen. I know. Yeah, it's
not
Cora,
okay.
It's okay.
No,
it's fine.
Not.
Just calm down. All right. It's okay. Cora, okay. Cora, listen to me. Cora. Okay. Do you promise to believe me that what I'm about to tell you isn't meant to make you feel worse? The reason why my brother Robbie isn't here with me tonight is because he died a year ago from leukemia. And just listen. Robbie loved Bob Marley. Like, he loved Bob Marley. And I'm learning to love him too. But Robbie, he believed with all of his heart that every little thing is gonna be all right.
It's the mistakes in life that make it all worthwhile, you know? This is not the end of the world. This we can fix. Because you know what they say. You know, when life hands you lemons, you make lemonade. A journey of 1,000 miles.
Begins with the first step. I guess it's back to the drawing board.
We can't fix this, right?
We can fix this. Even if it takes all night.
That's terrible. I'm gonna steal it. I don't care.
Oh,
it's so bad, it's good. Cora.
I believe with every fiber of my being that tattoos are a window into the soul. And while I have a bone to pick with most cliches when it comes to my work, I will never again take them for granted. Behind every cliche, just like every tattoo, there is a hidden meaning and a history of truth. And that is a cliche I can live by. Morning.